Hello and welcome everyone. This is a special edition of video lecture series brought to you by the Legal Aid Clinic of Dr. Ram Manohar Lohiya, National Law University at Lucknow. In these specific video lecture series, we'll be recording laws and providing them to you in as crisp a format as possible. In today's video, we'll be discussing divorce by mutual consent.
So, broadly speaking first, how is the law on divorce governed in India?
India is a multicultural society. Therefore, various religions are governed by various personal laws. For example, Hindus are governed by the Hindu Marriage Act. Christians are governed by the Indian Christian Marriage Act. So there are various personal laws that govern various religions.
Can you, for the benefit of our viewers, categorize divorce into certain categories so that it is easier for our viewers to understand?
So divorce in India can be broadly categorized into two main categories. Firstly is divorce by mutual consent, and secondly it's contested divorce.
What is the difference between divorce by mutual consent and contested divorce?
Look, in divorce by mutual consent, both the parties to a divorce, that is the husband and wife, agree to mutually separated from each other. While in a contested divorce, one wants a divorce while the other is not wanting it and therefore contesting it in a court of law.
Can we generally conclude that a divorce by mutual consent is easier to obtain?
Yes, divorce by mutual consent is much easier to obtain. It's shorter, it's less taxing for both the parties.
Before we ask you as to what is the procedure for obtaining a divorce by mutual consent, can you please tell us about two to three things which parties who are willing to obtain a divorce by mutual consent, those things which these parties are supposed to keep in mind?
So before you even decide to approach the court, there are two very important things that you need to consider. You can sit down together in a place and decide either in the presence of lawyer or without your lawyers. Firstly is the custody of your children, if you have any. That is, who is going to keep the children, and if you're going to jointly share the custody of children, then for what time period is the mother and father going to keep them. Secondly, it's about maintenance. Now we need to be very specific. There are no minimum or maximum amount that can be fixed for maintenance in a divorce by mutual consent.
So starting with the procedure on divorce by mutual consent, if a person, let's say one of our viewers, wants to obtain a divorce by mutual consent, which is the forum that is supposed to be approached? What is the procedure which is governing this divorce, and how easy or difficult is this divorce by mutual consent to obtain?
So when you approach the court, you will have to first approach a district court. You will have to first approach the district court in your area, where you'll have to file a petition for divorce by mutual consent. You need to specifically specify that you've been living separately for a year. After that, the court will hear you out, give you a date between 6 to 18 months, which is called the cooling off period.
So what is this cooling off period that you mentioned about?
So this cooling off period, which lasts from 6 to 18 months, is a period given by court where you reconsider whether you want to obtain a divorce or you want to mutually reconcile.
So once a cooling off period is ordered by court, let's say two parties, husband and wife, both of them approach the court with a petition signing that they want a divorce by mutual consent, and court gives a cooling off period of 10 months. Upon the expiry of this period of 10 months, are the parties compelled in law to appear before the court? Are they supposed to appear as a matter of obligation?
Look, if you don't appear at the end of this cooling off period, then the court will presume that you two have reconciled and your divorce petition will fail.
So you are saying that the court will presume the divorce petition as withdrawn if the parties to the divorce do not appear before the court after the cooling off period?
Absolutely.
And once the parties do appear after the cooling period, what is the procedure that follows?
Once the party appear at the end of this cool-off period, the court will pass a decree for divorce, and after that, those two persons would legally be considered as divorced. In our next video, we'll be discussing about contested divorce and the procedure associated with them.